there are three things you can reset back to default: the drive, the soft PLC, and the fan runtime. Resetting the WEG CFW300 drive to factory default is super easy. If I go to parameter 204, set it to a 5, the drive resets, and we're good to go. That's all there is to it. Now, that reset all of the drive parameters to factory default, except for the drive's rated current, rated line voltage, and the serial address. That's good to know that you don't lose the drive's serial bus address, because that means you'll still be able to communicate with the drive after a reset, assuming you're using the default COM channel parameters. It also resets the user parameters 910 through 959. If you were using the built-in PID app, then they get reset to the defaults shown in the user manual. If you were using a custom soft PLC app, then they get reset to whatever your soft PLC app had assigned as the default values. This reset command will also stop the soft PLC and switch it back to the built-in PID function. Your soft PLC program is still there, it hasn't gone away, it was just turned off. For example, I have a simple soft PLC app running that lights this indicator to show me what the state of the switch is. I see parameter 901 is a 1, which means the soft PLC app is running, and parameter 903 is a 0, which means I'm using a soft PLC app and not the built-in PID function. So if I go to parameter 204 and enter a 5 to reset the drive, I see my app is no longer working. Now, since we reset the drive parameters, we need to go back to drive parameter 275 and set it to a 37. That tells the drive that digital output 1 is being used by the soft PLC. Now, if I go to parameter 903, I see it got reset to the built-in PID function. I'll change that back to my soft PLC app. And parameter 901 after the drive reset says the soft PLC is stopped. So I'll change that back to run the program. And sure enough, my switch and indicator are working again. Perfect. So the key point to understand is the drive reset disables the soft PLC app. It doesn't erase it. You can also reset only the soft PLC parameters by setting parameter 204 to an 11. If you were running the built-in PID function, then that resets parameters 910 through 959 to the factory defaults shown in the user manual. If you are running a custom soft PLC app, then it resets those parameters to whatever defaults the soft PLC app had set up for those parameters. Now, this reset doesn't stop the soft PLC app. That is, it doesn't change these parameters. And finally, you can reset the fan timer. That's so when you replace the fan, you can reset the fan runtime. Now, could you reset the drive from the WEG programming software? Well, technically yes. I could search for load save to find the parameter, and I could set it to a 5. But we don't recommend resetting the drive from the WPS software. Why? Because if the software was in the middle of updating something or changing something, and you issue a factory reset in the middle of it, there's a chance that that reset could interrupt that when it power cycles the drive, and that would leave things in an unknown state. So it's best to avoid any possible issues and always do a drive reset from the drive's HMI. If you are using WPS, then be sure to disconnect WPS from the drive to get a clean exit. Now, that can take several seconds while WPS finalizes everything for a clean disconnect, so be patient. Keep an eye on this little green connection indicator down here. When it turns gray, you know WPS is fully disconnected from the drive. When that's done, then you can do a drive reset from the drive's keypad, and when that's done, then you can reconnect WPS. This load save command is also used to load and save user parameters. We'll do a separate video on that feature. Well, that ought to be enough to get you up and running with factory reset. Click here to learn more about the WEG CFW300 variable frequency drive. Click here to learn about Automation Direct's free award-winning support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.